The games begin, don't tell anybody, but even before the opening ceremony for the Summer Olympic Games in Tokyo, the first event is already underway in Japan.
I just want to tell you something. You know, we host the Olympics a lot on NBC, and yes. I've got a collection of the pins. Do you still have your pins?
I have my little pin, yes.
Yeah, and they just say different cities on them.
And it says 2020 for the one we got for these games, but it's 2021, so I was expecting a new pin, but it still says 2020.
Oh, it doesn't say 2020. Are we going to get one? Did you get a pin?
I think they're still calling it 2020, even though it's 2021, because it's officially the 2020
games. That's right. It is the 2020 games.
And we got more coming up in 2022, hopefully.
But we do have a little collection of pins. It's kind of nice. And the games were delayed by a year because of the pandemic, as Wilson said. The first event was a softball game between Japan and Australia. It took place in Fukushima, north of Tokyo, with no spectators and under tight security. A trio of two-run homers drove Japan to an 8-1 victory. Japan is seeking its second consecutive gold and fourth straight Olympic medal in softball. And while you were sleeping, the United States began its quest to regain the Olympic softball gold medal. Kat Osterman pitched one-hit ball over six innings, striking out nine to beat Italy 2-0. The Americans lost their title to Japan, their biggest rivals, 3-1 at Beijing in 2008. The opening ceremony for the Olympic Games is on Friday.
All right, Carmen, Tuesday was an eventful day at the Summer Olympic Games in Tokyo, and there is another full day ahead.
The U.S. is racking up medals in the pool, 16 total now. Take a look at the full medal count. Team USA firmly in the lead with 30 medals. China is in second with 24 total medals, but is tied with Japan in golds, both nations reporting 11 each. The host nation, Japan, sits in third with 20 Olympic medals. American Katie Ledecky further cementing her name as a swimming legend in a race, making its Olympic debut. Ledecky wins gold in the Olympics' first ever 1,500-meter freestyle for women. She swam to victory more than 3 seconds ahead of U.S. teammate Erica Sullivan, who took silver.
Four-time gold medalist Simone Biles will not defend her Olympic title. The American gymnastics superstar has now withdrawn from the all-around competition to focus on her mental well-being. The decision comes a day after Biles removed herself from the team final after just one rotation because she felt she was not mentally ready to continue. Jade Carey, who finished ninth in qualifying, will take Biles' place in the all-around. USA Gymnastics said Biles will be evaluated before deciding whether to compete in next week's individual events. The U.S. women's gymnastics team went on to win silver without Biles competing. Her exit meant teammate Jordan Childs had to quickly prepare routines on the uneven bars and balance beam. Gymnast Suni Lee took Biles' spot on the floor exercise. The Russian Olympic Committee won gold in that event. Childs and teammate Grace McCollum will be on the Today Show this morning to talk about the sudden shift in competition, what it was like, and how they support their teammates. That's coming up at 7 this morning here on WLBT.
More powerful stories emerging from the Tokyo Olympics.
U.S. swimmers and gymnast Simone Biles all making headlines. NBC's Kurt Gregory joins us live from Tokyo this morning with the latest on what's happening at the Games. Kurt, good morning.
Good morning, Wilson, Cheryl. Good morning, everybody. Let's talk a little swimming first, and we'll talk some sports dynasties. You think of the Yankees, you think of the Patriots. Well, add USA swimming to that list. All Olympic swimmers from the U.S. continue to do is just pile up the medals, Olympiad after Olympiad. And here today in Tokyo, four more in the pool.
Katie Ledecky to the wall.
Katie Ledecky adds to her legacy, powering her way to Olympic gold in the grueling women's 1500 meters and sharing an Olympic moment with teammate Erica Sullivan, who wins silver.
Man, really got my mindset right, and I knew it was going to be tough, and man, I'm so happy for Erica.
More U.S. medals in the women's 200 individual medley. Alex Walsh and Kate Douglas win silver and bronze.
I love you guys, but you're going to be this high.
U.S. gymnastics great Simone Biles stunned the world when she withdrew from the women's team final.
And once I came out here, I was like, no, mental is not there, so I just need to let the girls do it and focus on myself.
Without their leader, Team USA persevered, winning silver.
But I feel like we pulled it all together, and I'm really proud of all of us.
No goals for U.S. women's soccer, but a scoreless draw against Australia moves the team through to the quarterfinals. And a chance to rebound. The U.S. men bounced back, beating Iran. Next up, the Czech Republic on Saturday.
And a chance for a gold medal tonight here in Tokyo for Team USA. Women's 3-on-3, they'll take on the Russian athletes. And we're hoping that this rock brings them some good mojo. Wilson, Cheryl, back to you.
Very good, Kurt. Back to gymnastics. What's the latest on Simone Biles and her status as we look ahead?
Right. The initial news, not good. We found out a couple hours ago Simone Biles will not be ready for the individual all-around tomorrow here in Tokyo. Now, the good news is she has qualified across all four individual apparatus. So we're talking bars, beam, vault, and floor. That's all good. It's all next week. So Simone has a chance to rest and heal, and we certainly hope she gets herself in a good place because she's got not just a country, but a globe cheering her on. Back to you.
Very good. We shall see. Kurt Gregory live in Tokyo.
Ashley, thank you. Well, the coronavirus has claimed another Olympic dream. Unfortunately, Sam Kendricks, a former Ole Miss track and Olympic bronze medalist, will not compete in Tokyo after testing positive for COVID. Wednesday night, the United States Olympic and Paralympic Committee tweeted that in alignment with the local rules and protocols, Kendrick has been transferred to a hospital to be placed in isolation. USOPC said no further information will be released at this time. In Olympics, where many of the U.S. favorites have faltered, Caleb Dressel lived up to the hype.
Dressel claimed the first individual gold medal of his career with a victory in the 100-meter freestyle. Dressel held off the defending Olympic champion, Australia's Kyle Chalmers, with a furious sprint to the wall. The winning time was an Olympic record of 47.02 seconds. Dressel beat Chalmers by a mere 0.06 of a second. The first three gold medals of Dressel's career were all in the relays, and now he has one that he earned all by himself. Love it. A historic run for the U.S. women's 3x3 baseball team. They faced the Russian Olympic Committee in the event's inaugural gold medal game. The U.S. women stormed out to a 7-2 lead and never looked back. Stephanie Dolson and Kelsey Plum combined for 12 points as Team USA defeated Russia 18-15 to capture that gold. Dolson, Plum, along with Alicia Gray and Jackie Young, finished with an 8-1 record, only falling to Japan in pool play.
All right, tonight on WLBT, the gymnastics women's all-around competition will go on without defending gold medalist Simone Biles, who pulled out citing struggles with her mental health. Now, while Biles is out of the competition, Suni Lee and Jade Carey are the Team USA's competitors in today's final and face the biggest moment of their careers. Good luck to them. Lee, who is known for her complex routines on the uneven bars, came in third place in the qualifying round and is a contender for all-around gold. Carey, who up until yesterday didn't even know she'd be in the final competition, came in ninth in qualifying. Now you can watch that tonight at 7 during primetime coverage of the games. Also, live coverage of multiple swimming events, and right after WLBT News at 10, we have coverage of qualifying rounds of men's and women's track and field. Also, the finals for men's and women's BMX racing and cycling.
Now here's a live look at the Olympic cauldron in Tokyo, where the flame continues to burn as the games enter its seventh day, and things are looking so good for Team USA out there. Last night, track and field events got started with the women laying down some very fast times in the 100-meter heats. Mississippi's own Shelby McEwen advanced in the men's high jump. The Abbeville native made his first appearance at the Olympics last night. He competed in the qualifying round of the men's high jump, where he cleared the bar at more than 7'5". Team USA is eyeing several medals in the track and field events. And here's a look at the full medal count now. The United States continues to hold strong as number one in the medal count with 41 total medals, but falls behind China with the most gold medals at 18. The Russian Olympic Committee is inching closer to the two leaders with 33 medals total. Now, one of those gold medals belongs to USA gymnast Suni Lee.
That's right, the 18-year-old from Minnesota made history becoming the first Asian American woman to win an all-around gold medal at the Olympic Games. Lee came in third in the qualifying round in Tokyo and had widely been known as the second best gymnast in the nation, just behind Simone Biles. Biles' decision to withdraw from the competition for mental health reasons cleared the way for Lee to take the gold. Her gold medal continues the legacy of American dominance in women's gymnastics and cements her place in the sport's history. And coming up this morning, Suni Lee will join the Today Show to talk about her journey to taking the all-around top spot in Tokyo. That's coming up at 7 right here on WLBT.